Danke!
So I embarrassed him because I'm nervous to give a speech.
It's okay, Zaki, don't worry.
Zaki!
So I'm gonna cut to the chase. So you guys probably just relax and don't look at me too much.
Everyone's
all right. So it's definitely the So it's definitely the happiest day of my life, you can see for yourself. And inshallah, it is only the beginning of his happiness, inshallah, for both my brother and my puppy. To be fair, he has been out of this world ever since he met my puppy, my sister-in-law. He goes to work with a big smile. He comes back from work with a big smile. He watches TV with a big smile. He even sleeps with a smile on his face. So, and it's amazing. I mean, those who know my brother, you know that, you know, he's always friendly, he has a smile on his face. But this smile is it's different, it's more meaningful, and that's how I know that my brother is really happy. So my brother talks to my puppy like every single night, ever since his engagement 8 months ago. And I was like very curious. So as an economist, I looked at the call records and I calculated the average.
What?
It was estimated to be around 40 minutes. 2 minutes is a long time, so I just had to ask my brother. Do you guys always talk like 40 minutes nonstop? And my brother says, no. And I was like, really? And then he says, yeah, but it's okay. I just like the fact that, you know, she's on the other end of the line with me. So now I don't know what you guys, but I think that's like real love right there. I mean, you don't always have to talk to show your love. So I think it's amazing. So it is a happy day for everyone in my family, but it is also a sad day for me because I'm losing my longest ever roommate. In fact, he was there as far as my memory can take me back, and he always has that smile as I tell you. So even in my earliest memories, I see him like smiling back at me and, you know, just, you know, loving me and taking care of me. But it doesn't mean that, you know, we didn't have fun and, you know, have fun at the expense of each other like all brothers do.
Hey!
Yeah, different table.
Anyway, so I was going to say that, I guess, and he's the only roommate that actually saw me naked.
What?
That's 4 years old. And when I was 5 years old.
Yeah, someone should have proofread this speech.
So I'm not the only roommate that actually misses him. Messi misses him a lot. Messi is our cat. And he really misses him. So let me tell you a story. I guess for the last whole year, Messi stepped on his foot, like on the corner of the bed. Now, for the whole year, so never even once he came to my bed. Like, our beds like really next to each other. Now, so even when my brother is not there, he still sleeps on the couch bed. Never once at night. So, and right now my brother is kind of like, you know, kicked him out because I was not a big fan of cat yet. So, anyway, so now Messi, to train him, he keeps him out of the room. And Messi just misses him dearly. So every night, and even in the morning, like, he just meows. Now, we all know, like, regular cat meow, but for my brother, he has a special kind of meow. It's like, you know, like, he's really annoyed and he really wants in his life. But anyway, what I want to tell you this story is just because I just want to show that even a cat like loves my brother dearly. That just shows how much my brother actually loves him, for him to miss him that much. It's amazing. So I don't know how much time do I have. I can go all night long. So that's
cool. How does he meow?
Anyway, so I do remember a story which I want to share with you. When we were really young in Bangladesh, I guess I was about 9, 10, we used to go fishing. I guess it is a Bengali wedding, so I was really fish. And we also played cricket, like many other basic kids right here. So that was among the many other, you know, adventures and misadventures me and my brother we, you know, took in our life. We carried in our life. So anyway, one evening we went fishing, then we played cricket with our local boys, but in addition there were some outside boys, I guess, friends of friends. Anyway, one of the outside boys that I got into a fight. Now, this guy was a big guy, he was older than me. So I guess he was probably mad at me because I hit a six on his, you know, pitching spell or bowling spell. I don't know, I guess everyone's confused, but it's okay. Anyway, basically I owned him because that's one way of saying it. But he was a really big guy and he didn't really take it. So basically, we got into a fight and he was trying to push a raw fish in my mouth. We're not in Japan, so like raw fish is not delicacy, it's more of an insult, just to be clear. And anyway, out of nowhere, I see my brother kind of like coming in with a flying kick and takes the big guy out of the picture.
Wow.
Yeah!
Ibrahim!
Anyway, those who know my brother, you know him as really calm, and he's really, like, he's calm and reserved, and he'll never get into some kind of, any kind of fight. But basically, when someone messes with his loved ones, he is trouble, so he's going to take care of it. So, anyway, keeping us very strong and protecting when someone troubles his loved ones, that's what I'm
saying. What was that, Sean?
When someone puts a fish in his brother's mouth, he gets serious.
So my brother and I are best friends, and together we did many different things, many facets of life. You know, we read the same novels. I think most of the things that I did, he did them first. So basically, I just followed whatever he did. So that's he was really a role model to me throughout my life. So anyway, I just want to say that one day, when he was really young, he ran away from home. And he didn't really take me with him. And I was really mad, because I was like, he was really up to a lot of fun, and he didn't take me with him, so I was kind of mad. But anyway, and then what I realized was that he didn't take me with him because he didn't really know that it was safe or not for him, so he just didn't want to take his younger brother, because he didn't want him to get in trouble. So that's kind of what my brother is. You know, he wants to take initiatives, he really loves and protects his loved ones. And I know my dog only for several months, but it's enough to know that they really made for each other. It's just like the way they seem, you know, right now, and the way they talk to each other. And I can tell that that's like, really, and they have the qualities that complement each other. So that's amazing. Anyway, I wanted to say a story about my puppy recently, but I have to say it in Bangla, so all the non-Bengal speakers apologize, but you kind of expected it when you come to a Bengal wedding. So, and you already have some Bengal, you know, speeches. So, my auntie, my puppy family, our family, I'm not sure how to say it, I'm not sure how to say it. So, acting dinner, auntie, my puppy, I'm not sure how to say it. তো উনি বলছেন যে বাংলার কালচারে যে কীভাবে স্বামীর সেবা করতে হয়, স্বামীর দেখাশোনা করতে হয়। তো ভাই বলছেন তোমার স্বামী যখন তার হয়ে আসবে কাজ থেকে, তখন তুমি তোমার মাথা চেপে দেবে, হাত চেপে দেবে, জিজ্ঞেস করবে কি হয়েছে। তখন ভাবে বলছে আচ্ছা ওর গলাতে আমি ঢুকে দেবো। তো সেটা শুনে মানে আমরা সবাই বলতে গেলে মাটিতে গড়া করে দিচ্ছিলাম। তো ভাবি থ্যাংক ইউ ফর দ্যাট। আই নো এখানে not like this, but I have to say.
Translation!
Anyway, my speech. So, inshallah, I want to introduce some more people to come on board. First, I want to introduce my brother's colleague and respected elder, Lord Kanto, Tahid Islam. What's it, Allah?